People are watching me. They're watching me all the time. They're watching me even when they're pretending not to watch me. They're watching me to see how well I do this thing called human. Every dream I ever had came true. The person I never thought I was or could be, I am.
The show must go on, even though I've got a pain in my hip and a hole in the sole of my foot. The show must go on, even though there's times during it when I get so tired, I feel like I'm going to die. I can't give up. The show must go on.
To leave a message, and I will call you back as soon as possible. Thank you very much.
I can't hear. I called to say hello. I am L.A. and I'm doing excellent. Bye. Love
figures, which is open only Saturday and Sunday afternoons from 1 to 5 p.m. If you need a call back, leave your name and phone number. Please wait for the beep.
this is nuts. But becoming disabled is a marvelous thing to go through. even if a lot of it is hideous. It's a privilege, really. Like an odyssey to hell and back. You know, if everybody could do it and come out able-bodied, I'd really recommend it. Because once you've become disabled, you can't be on automatic pilot anymore. You can't be a human pinball batted around by other people's expectations. Let's face it, who wants the expectations they give disabled people? Don't you? I mean, we've been kicked out of the Pepsi generation, and we don't have the look you want to know better. You know, I'm not crazy about being disabled, but I like the way it shook up my life. It was a cherry bomb. You know, I'd like to take a cherry bomb right now and throw it at the wall between us. Oh, it's not so scary. Nothing on our side of the wall, but a lot of kind of wonderful people, just like you. If you would stop being such sissies. You know what Helen Keller said about risk? She said, security is mostly a superstition. Life is either a daring adventure or it's nothing. We think she's right.
The children in shopping centers always ask, what's wrong with your leg? Do you know what I say to them? I tell them I'm a mermaid.
Says the Berlin Wall may come down.
It's All Things Considered from National Public Radio.
The Soviet leader headed back today after a four-day visit to West Germany and calls for a common European home.
Which of the leaders the great powers played better in West Germany, Bush and Gorbachev, one-on-one?
We'll talk to two brothers, Neil and Roger Marcus, who appear in a play about Neil, who is and is not disabled. Roger speaks for his brother.
What? Neil?
You have a, I understand, a very serious case of this condition because your whole body is involved. But, Roger, is this progressive? Does it get worse than this?
Well, it is a progressive disorder. Neil has stabilized pretty much for about the, ever since a third brain operation, which was in 1965. He has ups and downs around that. You know, if you live with him day by day, you can notice these things. Most people on seeing him for the first time go, wow, because he's very impressive in his muscle spasms and strength. His build is almost like Arnold Schwarzenegger with his, he has very strong muscles.
I'd say a dancer's body. You do look like a ballet dancer.
I often call myself a dancer.
In his mind's eye, he's Fred Astaire. And although he can't dance, he can dance. And he does dance. And our eyes are glued to him. And he's beautiful. And he's beyond any shadow of a doubt that he is a star. Watching him, we are all stars. I say, put that man in a wheelchair and book him.
Neil Marcus can get out of his chair, and he does, on stage. He stands, and a muscle spasm pitches him forward, bending him double. He straightens again, and a spasm lifts his leg. Like a dancer, he balances, and his arched and pointed foot drifts up and up, waist high, chest high. He falls back into the chair. He can't control it, but he dances.
Hey, The high point of our trip was meeting two young children or more who came to the show, one of whom had cerebral palsy. I sat down on the edge of the stage and I said to him, "So, how did you like the show?" And he leaned back his arms in a kind of a spastic way with a giant expression on his face, arms outstretched. And he said, "It was excellent." And his voice is echoing in my mind even today. I've been writing a lot about it because it was such a positive expression of being alive and being just thrilled to death. The other exciting news was on our trip that same night, another boy who had both hands decapitated at the wrist, or maybe he was a thalidomide child. I was told that during the beginning of the show, he was a little bit sad and a little walking around and not knowing exactly why he was at the show. And that by intermission, the same person who had seen him earlier saw him, and he was standing up tall and straight and looking people square in the eyes and saying, with his eyes, it was as if he was saying, "My friend Neil showed me that I'm okay." And I know that when I told my sister this story, we both burst into tears, and it was one of the most moving experiences of this last trip. And it points out that what we're doing cannot be bought, or it is something that just happens once in a lifetime, that you are riding a storm which has the power to change people's lives. And I wrote in my journal that night that without a doubt we changed those kids' lives. The other point that I wanted to make about the show in general is it became very clear to me that the storm reading is not about disability, that I've never thought about it as being a show about disability, but I'm going to change that now because there's one aspect of the show that is about disability, and that is that my brother Neil is a role model for disability and for everybody else. If you had seen the look in those kids' eyes and realized that they now know that there's a place for them in the world, and he made that place. And he made it by presenting them a different view of a condition which they share. Then that's really what the show is about. Concept of disability, and only that's the only aspect of it that's disabled. And really the show is about humanity and human liberation otherwise. And otherwise, I don't like to talk about the disabled issue. How's that?
Okay, you are the
okay.
twice, and let us try before we die to make a sense of life.
Deep thunder rolled around their shores. with the fires of Orc. Gundendaka, you not come here!
Not an easy man to see.
In those last moments, he loved life more than he ever had before. Not just his life, anybody's life, my life. All he wanted were the same answers the rest of us want. Where do I come from? Where am I going? How long have I got? All I could do was sit there and watch him die.
Thinking about this when I was driving up, that one thing that seems from my perspective to be so special about the position you're in stardom is that your path is crossing the paths of others that ordinarily you would never get to meet, and you're in a situation where it's so easy, or it's easier for them to approach you and fall in love with you. And feel so exciting witnessing it from my end.
Okay, that turns it on. That turns it on. Am I being recorded for posterity now?
Better.
The meaning of life is to keep breathing. Let's see what everybody else's is.
My meaning of life is to have fun since no one told us really what it's supposed to be like.
Me as well. What the hell?
Ditto what Asuya said for me.
Wrapped it around his arm.
Here's your philosophy.
Meaning
of
just
life.
Just a moment.
Oh, you've got to think of it.
It's not, oh, yeah, stop a minute, stop.
Okay.
Oh.